Hello everyone. A sphere is dropped under gravity through a viscous fluid. Taking the average acceleration to be half the initial acceleration, show that the time required to attain the terminal velocity is independent of the fluid density. Now look at the diagram here. When a sphere is just dropped, okay, in the liquid, it is just dropped. Which all forces are acting there? One is mg, which is acting vertically downward. At the same time, there is an upward force, is the say it as the buoyant force, or we can say it as the upthrust. So these forces are acting when the sphere is just dropped. Maybe after some time, look at this one, this is the initial position of the ball or a sphere when it is just dropped, and after some time it may reach at the second position, say it as the 2. Now, which all forces may act on the second position right now? Now you can see here, mg will be acting vertically downward, upthrust will be acting upward, at the same time there may be viscous force also acting upward. Now at the second point, we are considering that the ball or the sphere reached the terminal velocity. So what is the meaning of terminal velocity? When it will attain the terminal velocity? When upward force is equal to, when upward forces is equal to downward forces, okay? So downward forces, when both are equal, we can say that the resultant force is equal to zero. Therefore, what is the acceleration? Acceleration is equal to zero. So you just imagine, when the sphere is reached at the second position, it is reached the terminal velocity, therefore acceleration is equal to zero. Imagine the initial acceleration is equal to a1 and the second position acceleration, you say it as the a2. So what is the average acceleration? Is equal to a1 plus a2 divided by 2. So what is the average acceleration, which is equal to a1 by 2? It is already given the acceleration to be half the initial acceleration. So average acceleration, we got it right now. Now look at the diagram here. What is the resultant force initially? The resultant force is equal to, we can use a Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. So resultant force is equal to ma. What is the resultant force when it is just dropped? You can see the mg minus, what is upthrust formula? V rho g. So just imagine the density of the liquid, you say it as rho zero, and the density of the material, you can write it as a rho. So what is the formula become upthrust? Upthrust is the force acting on the body by the fluid, right? So we can write here V rho zero g, which is equal to mass into acceleration. So we can write here, what is a m? M stand for density is equal to mass by volume, right? So mass is equal to what? Density into volume of the material. So we can write the rho v g minus rho zero v g, which is equal to m into a. Okay, what is a m? Once again, the mass of the material, that is equal to, once again we can write the v rho into a. Okay, v rho into a. So now what all things, you can take it outside, v g can be take it outside, into remaining one, rho minus rho zero is equal to v rho a. V cancel. So what is the acceleration? Acceleration is equal to g into rho minus rho zero divided by rho. Okay, so right now we got the initial acceleration, so we can write it as the a1. So what is the average acceleration? We can write now average acceleration, a average is equal to a1 by 2, right? So what is the a1? G into rho minus rho zero divided by rho divided by 2. So we can write here average acceleration is equal to g by 2 into rho minus rho zero divided by rho. Now what is happening after some time when the sphere is reached at the second position? It reaches the terminal velocity. So we can use the formula here, v is equal to u plus at. That is, v, we can write it as the terminal velocity, which is equal to initial velocity plus average acceleration, okay, average acceleration into time. It is asking that They show that the time required to attain the terminal velocity is independent of the fluid density. Okay, so we have to calculate here the time formula. So just to substitute for the terminal velocity, what is the terminal velocity formula? 2 by 9 g r square rho minus rho 0 divided by eta, which is equal to, what is the initial velocity when it is just dropped? The so u is equal to 0. What is the average acceleration? That is equal to g by 2 into rho minus rho 0 divided by rho into t. Okay, so what all things can cancel here right now? G can cancel here. Okay, g can cancel, rho minus rho 0 can cancel. So what we can write now, 2, you can take it this side. So 4 by 9, remaining one r square is the rho, can be taken to left side. So it become rho, which is equal to t. So what is the basic formula we got now? T is equal to, once again, there is a eta is already there. So eta. So t is equal to 4 r square rho divided by 9 eta. So look at the equation here. The time, okay, the time to attain the terminal velocity is depends upon the density of the material. It is independent of the fluid density. So hence we proved the relation. Okay, hope you understood this one. Thank you.